tonight's annual spring show entitled School Days. Tonight, we are proud to present an original production filled with tap, jazz, acro, hip-hop, lyrical, contemporary, and ballet, and a lot of entertainment. This is a full studio production, and the dancers in tonight's show range from age 3 to 38. I ask that you please dispose of any outside food and beverages that are not water, as we have been fined in the past due to spills and messes being left in this theater. If we want to continue using these amazing theaters, we all need to respect the rules that are created. No one is exempt from the rules of society, not even me. I thank you for your cooperation. Tonight's show runs about 15 minutes longer than our usual show. For that, I apologize. But as your butts numb and you begin to curse me, you will also thank me because these dancers are truly an amazing sight to see. And this show is one for the books. One of the things that we do each year at our spring show is award the title of Miss Studio 49. I wanted to touch on the original intent of this award, which began back in 2006 when it was awarded to Rebecca Lyons and called the Dance Passion Award. It was given based not just on skill, but on a dancer's commitment and love of the art of dance. I am fortunate enough to have Rebecca here helping behind the scenes tonight, and I would like her to come out and say a few brief words on what it meant for her to receive this award.
When she created the Passion Award, along with all the other awards, I became very motivated, but also very nervous because I was surrounded by incredibly good dancers. After the performance was over, it was time for the awards. One by one, all my close friends got called for Most Improved Tap, Most Improved Acro, Most Improved Jazz. As each name was called, I remember I had my knees to my chest, and I was slowly bringing them closer and closer, and my head going down. I was just like, man, I'm so disappointed in myself, I'm not winning anything. And then she began to describe the Passion Award. And I remember just sitting there, just blocking it out, not even paying attention anymore. I was just like, God, just so disappointed. And sitting there with my head down, and then suddenly she announced my name. And I remember, I had tears in my eyes because I was so sad. And I looked up and caught eye contact with her. And she was just looking at me, so proud. And it was like the biggest moment ever. I was so excited. Then I went out and just started crying. I was just like, it was just crazy. It was almost 10 years ago, but I mean, felt really great at the time. I never forgot it. Such a big moment. And thank you.
And then I started the evening out crying, which I never do. I feel a lot of fun. Thank you, Rebecca. And you'll get a little taste of background stage. It's awesome. This year's show is focusing on the theme of school. And as I have grown and learned about being a dance teacher, a parent, a studio owner, and a human being who is always a work in progress, I have the desire to have my choreography reflect an even deeper range of subject matter than just your basic, here's a dance. Tonight's show ranges from playful, comedic numbers, which make you laugh, to numbers that reflect strong technique and the true art of dance, to pieces that show more serious, thoughtful notes. Please feel free to laugh if you find something funny, applaud when you love what the dancers do, and participate in the talent you will see on stage before you. We always enjoy ourselves more when the crowd gets into it. This year, I am excited to have choreographed two pieces to spoken words, both of which are written by one of my dancers and good friend, Bethann Kapansky. Bethann came to me a year ago with her poetry, and when I read the words, I knew I wanted to collaborate with her and create choreography that brought them to life visually. Tonight, I have asked Bethann to share her work with us and begin the evening with a poem. Bethann Kapansky.
Spoken song. It's a dance of words, if you will. So the words that I will be dancing we are all enrolled, our lessons played out, and a rest of days. Like the moment we breathe in crayons and capital letters in the classroom for the very first time, saying goodbye to smaller days, as we learn what it means to leap off the cliff of safe familiar into the strange place of unknown, hoping life will help us figure out how to grow wings so we don't fall down. Or like the time we do fall down, and we learn what it is to hurt, to fail. Maybe we aren't picked, aren't asked, or accepted. We know what it is to feel less than. Maybe failure comes when you realize you're in remedial reading the third year in a row because you still cannot comprehend that it is she, not Sahuk. Years later, when your high school English teacher grades a D on your final exam telling you your words fall down on page and you don't know how to write, you realize two things about falling down. One, what people say to us when we are down in the pavement matters and will stay with us long after the speaker has left the room. Two, don't ever let anyone clip your precious wings and keep you from flying fast and free after a dream. Like the way we flew fast and free around the playground, chasing one another in joy, wonder, and innocence, which begins to fade all too quickly as our limbs stretch and the days grow longer and the growing pains of life start to get harder when we finally get down to the real heart of the matter that is. The fragile sign stamped on the tender box of our heart is quite right. It will break easy if not handled with care. And it doesn't matter if you're 5 or 75 or 13 or 42 or 33 years old standing there with the hollow and the trunk in your outer chest wondering, am I going to make it? And your dance teacher tells you she still believes in you, life will keep on turning, and that falling down is simply unexpected floor work until we find our feet again and life begins to look up. Meanwhile, pain is pain is pain, here to teach us how to let go and break ourselves open so we can become more than, better, bigger than what we were before as we realize the matter of our own magnificence. Like the time I sat in a science class of the bright sky and lamp and moon looking up at the dust of matter above, lighting our way and giving us hope when the light of our day has gone out, realizing that same matter is running through our darkest veins and we are all connected, and life is just one big school to teach us this. What we do matters. What we say matters. Who we are matters. We are born knowing what matters. The problem is we easily forget and spend the rest of our lives learning what we know and all along. Connection. Compassion. Love.
Ladies and gentlemen, school is in session.